my bulge, it's still gold. I used to lose my voice in football games. I used to lose my voice and steal stuff of the world. But praise His holy name, I can lose my voice for Him. Thank God, 2 years ago when I was coming up over Sam's Gap, coming from work, there's a man named Jesus jumped in that MSD work truck. There it is, a sewer truck. Jesus come right in there beside me. And that whole pen, I've already heard that tonight. Thank His holy name for coming to where I was. And I defend the world. Praise His holy name tonight. Thank you, Lord. He's the best friend I've ever had. I'm here today tonight. If my wife was to die, my kids was to die, I was out there in the parking lot all by myself. Nothing around, just trees. I still got the best friend I've ever had. What He done to me. Thank you, Lord. First Kings. Chapter 17. I got that warm water now, didn't I? Starting verse 1, it says, Elijah, the Tishbite, who was in the inhabitants of Gilead, have a hard time saying that, said unto Ahab, as the Lord God of Israel liveth before whom I stand, there shall not be dew nor rain these years, but according to my word. Yeah. And the word of the Lord come unto him, saying, get thee hence, and turn thy eastward, and hide thyself by the brook Cherith that is before Jordan. And it shall be that thou shalt drink of the brook, and I have commanded the ravens to feed thee there. So he went and did according unto the word of the Lord, and he went and dwelt by the brook Cherith that is before Jordan, and the ravens brought him bread and flesh in the morning, and bread and flesh in the evening, and he drank of the brook. I'll keep reading, so keep your spot there, but I got to read this, and Elijah come to Ahab, and God came to Elijah and he hid him behind the brook that's named Cherith. And I got thinking about this brook. Why can't you find this brook on a map? What's so important about this brook? I got to studying that, and the Lord showed me that there was a word there, Cherith. And I got to studying that and started reading what that means. And that means to be cut off. It's what Cherith means. That sometimes that we got to be cut off from the world. We got to be cut off from the things of this world. Because if not, it will overcome you. You can be cut off. God will put you. He took Elijah to put him over here beside this brook. Why did he do it? He told some ravens that he's going to feed them. Elijah knowed that them ravens didn't have no sense to feed him, because he knows what happened with Noah did. They sent Noah sent the ravens out, and they went out. They didn't come back any. But all of a sudden, God's going to send the ravens to Elijah and bring them food. He's going to bring them meat and bread. Praise His holy name. I'm here to tell you tonight, when you get cut off, when you feel like you're getting down and out, go down there beside the brook, because God promised you He's going to take care of you. Praise His holy name. When you get tired, whenever you get worried, go down there beside the brook, because He's going to feed you. Praise His holy name.
Amen.
Is it? While I was studying this, the Lord started showing me. I've been studying. I was supposed to preach this first night, but God said, no, you ain't. But praise His holy name. And I got to thinking about this. Whenever Elijah was sitting there, and he was sitting beside that brook, every time one of them ravens would fly in and fly off, I could just imagine him start getting hungry and say, Lord, where's the next one? Where's the next one, Lord? Lord, where's the next one at? But praise His holy name, He kept His promise and then come in there. And I could just keep imagining about that brook each day. And it kept getting smaller and smother and say, Lord, you told me that you have given me water by this brook. Every day it kept getting smaller and smaller. Lord, help me. It's getting smaller. And as he's sitting there, I can imagine whenever the last little drop of water come up that rock and absorbed in the ground, he said, God, where you at? And then the Lord come to him and said, hey, go to Zarephath. There's a little widow woman there that's going to sustain me. That's his only name. When you say you can't go on, when you say there ain't no way I can go on anymore, I'm going to take my Bible. I'm going to do like most of the world. I'm going to set it on the mantle and walk by it. Praise his holy name. Amen. Did you know the Bible's the most selling book in the world?
Yeah.
Then why is there more lost people than Christians? Praise his holy name.
Amen.
Let's keep it reading. And the word of the Lord came unto him saying, arise, get thee to Zarephath, which belong to Zidon, and dwell there. Behold, I have commanded a widow woman there to sustain thee. So he arose and went to Zarephath. And when he came to the gate of the city, behold, the widow woman was there, gathering her sticks. And he called her and said, fetch me, I pray thee, a little water in a vessel that I may drink. And as she was going to fetch it, he called to her and said, bring me, I pray thee, a morsel of bread in thy hand. Hold you, please. Bless his holy name. Could you imagine that? Elijah knows what God just done for him. He seen all that God just done. And he went to this little widow woman that was preparing her last. She was finding firewood to mount the last fire. That way she could cook a piece of bread. And they was going to die. That's what was getting ready to happen. He told her, he said, hey, fetch me a little bit of water. And I could think, I just think, she was going, he's stupid. This, we're in a drought, and he told me to go get some water. He told me my last little bit of water. But she said, all right, I'll do it. And as she was walking, I'm sure he had a grin on his face and said, hey, maybe a little cake of bread, a little morsel of bread. Yeah. Praise his holy name. So she turned around, and she said, and she said, as the Lord thy God liveth, I am not a cake, but a handful of meal in a barrel, a little oil in a course. And behold, I'm gathering two sticks that I may go in and dress it for me and my son, that we may eat it and die. All I got is two little sticks. That's all I got. I can't die. I'm drunk together. And if they're not much, deal, they're not much. They're all I got. They're all I got. I got this little bit of hole. I got this little cat. They're not much. I can't do that. My friends are telling me I can't, but he can. Praise his holy name. This is all I need, Lord. Praise his holy name. Whenever David was down there, he's getting ready to find that Philistine, and he pulled out of his bag a little rock. That rock ain't nothing. That rock ain't nothing. Until he picked it up, and God came to him and anointed that rock, and it sunk into his forehead. Praise his holy name. That rock ain't nothing till God anoints it. That rock ain't nothing. Praise God. Remember, when you get down, the world says you ain't nothing. Praise his holy name. Oh, yes, I am. Why? Because of God anointed me. Praise his holy name.
Amen.
Pray for me. This whole world today, you ain't nothing. my son. And then said the Lord God, for Israel, the barrel meal shall not waste, neither shall the course of oil fail until the day that the Lord sends rain upon the earth. Think about that. She took Elijah, she went in there, and she made that little cake of bread. And I'm sure that little cake of bread was made with tears. That was her last bit. And she's probably looking at her son, and you're going to die. And she was making that little cake, and she wanted to take it to Elijah. And she said, oh God, this is it. And then she took it to him, and I'm sure he had a smirk on his face. Said, go check that barrel. And I began to pray. Tears crying. And she walked up there, and she got down at the bottom of the barrel. And she said, no, remember, when you're at the bottom of your barrel, God's at the top.
Amen. How empty she borrowed.